good morning, friends at various centers in the country and the participants who are sitting in this television studio. My name is Dr. Sunil Dutt. I'm professor of education and education management at this institute. Basically, I am a science postgraduate, did my MSc honors in chemistry, thereafter shifted to education, did my post-graduation and PhD in education technology, all from Punjab University, Chandigarh. And after working for about 2.5 years in industries, I joined teaching profession as a lecturer in a college of education and taught to postgraduate classes in education for about 7 years. I joined this institution in 1992 as a lecturer and became professor of education in 2011. Since 2005, I am heading the academic cell of the institute, which is responsible for admission and examination of Master of Engineering program and PhD program. I'm also working as Central Public Information Officer under RTI Act since 2005. And I have to my credit 49 papers in various national and international journals, and also presented equal number of papers in conferences and seminars. I have to my credit 33 PhD dissertations registered with Punjab University Chandigarh, and presently 7 more students are pursuing their PhD program. Now coming to this theme, today's theme. Now if I ask you, go to library, you are sitting here, obviously you would ask why, means what is the objective. So for every activity there is a goal. Goal is something one wishes to achieve, and in order to reach a goal you need a plan that involves the listing and the interaction of various activities, and those activities are performed one by one in a specific order. So you need a plan that involves number of tasks. And what is a task? Task is nothing but a series of activities or actions which are required to achieve a goal. A task is a structured set of activities. It means it has a structure. It involves problem solving, or it involves selecting amongst alternative actions. And what is the action? Action is the smallest task which has no structure, which has no problem solving. Say placing this paper from this place to this place. So this is a small action. Okay, it has no structure. So you have goal, you have task, and you have actions. So in order to reach a goal, you require a number of tasks or subtasks which are to be performed. And the second question is, in what sequence? So this these two questions are answered by a technique called as task analysis. So task analysis, this is the session for today's this particular time. So task analysis. Actually, analysis means breaking down something into its constituent parts. So task analysis is nothing but a process of breaking down the complexity of any activity into easier steps. And these steps are then arranged in a sequence, and students are taught one by one in this sequence. Now, if you look around, many of day-to-day behaviors which we perform, even without attending to what we are doing, are complex, comprising of a number of, I would say, small steps, or the distinct or the discrete steps which are performed in a specific order. You can take an example of Yanga. So I said that many of the day-to-day behaviors which we perform without even attending to what we are doing are very much complex, comprising a number of tasks or subtasks to be performed in a specific order. Now take the case of brushing your teeth. Again, this particular task involves a number of actions to be performed one after the other in a particular sequence. For example, in order to brush teeth, the first task is pick up the toothbrush, wet the brush, take the cap of the tube, that is a paste, put paste on the brush, brush the outside of the bottom row of teeth, brush the outside of the top row of teeth, brush the biting surface of the top row of teeth, brush the biting surface of the bottom row of the teeth. Try to make yourself understood while answering the question of somebody outside the door, because you are also listening to somebody else. You are doing your job. Brush the inside surface of the bottom row of the teeth, brush the inside surface of the top row of the teeth, then spit, rinse the brush, replace the brush in the holder, grasp cup, fill cup with water, rinse teeth with water, spit, replace cup in holder, wipe mouth on sleeve, screw cap back on the tube, place tube back in the toilet kit. So a number of actions or small acts are required to be, because when you are teaching this particular technique, that is brushing the teeth, to a small child, you have to explain a number of tasks. Likewise, in our teaching, we need to know to what extent we have to deal with in a particular topic. Say the topic is to understand Ohm's law. Okay, so you will begin with the concept of current. For explaining the concept of current, you will need to explain you will need to define current, you need to tell the SI unit of current, you need to inform the students about the device which measures current. Likewise, you need to give the corresponding information about the voltage and the resistance, then draw the circuit diagram, okay, verify Ohm's law, draw a graph between V and I, and list situations where Ohm's law can be applicable. So what I have done is I have broken down the topic into its constituent parts, smaller and detailed units, and then I have arranged in a particular sequence. So that is why this task analysis is a process of breaking down the complexity of any activity into easier steps. And these steps are then taught to students or presented to students one by one in a sequence. So we have been teaching the theory subjects. We are also giving some demonstration in practical subjects or laboratories or workshops. All these involve number of task or subtask which are to be performed in a specific, which are to be performed. Perform means that in a laboratory or in a workshop you have to perform, whereas in a class, in a theory class, you have to deal with those components, isn't it? So it's a process of breaking down or analyzing a task into smaller and more detailed constituent units, and of then sequencing these units of analysis in an order of priority based upon their importance in the learning. So you see this triangle, inverted triangle. The at the top, the content is very, you can say, global, vague, and we are breaking down to the minutest element so that it can become self-explanatory. So it involves two things. One is the analysis. Analysis means breaking down. Then second is bringing a relationship, synthesis. Because from all those parts, these are the component parts. Component part will lead to the attainment of the broader topic. That is the aim of your topic. So it is a process of analyzing and articulating the kind of learning that you expect the learners to know how to perform. So there are basically three approaches to task analysis. The basic procedure is same, but depending upon the nature of the topic, we use these one of these three depending on the nature of the subject and the nature of the content. So one is the task decomposition, that is splitting the task into subtasks, and those subtasks are ordered. Okay, so these are then grouped together as plans. I'll give you a few examples that specify how the task might be performed in an actual situation. The second one is the knowledge-based technique. That is what the user knows about the task and how knowledge is organized about the brushing the teeth. Okay. Then the entity relation-based analysis, which involves relationships between objects and their actions in the task and the people who perform them. So relationship. Okay, I'll explain with a few illustrations. Let me give an example of decomposition, task decomposition. Say the objective is to borrow a book from the library. This is the objective. You look at the PPT, to borrow a book from the library. Now, what are the subtasks? First is go to library. Second is find required book. Third is retrieve the book from the shelf. Find the required book from the catalog. First of all, you will search for that particular book in the catalog. Then you will retrieve the book from the shelf. Okay. And then you will take the book to the counter for getting it issued. Now, let us analyze these. At the first level, borrow a book. This is the objective. The first level, we have divided this this process into subtasks. Now you can break down into the second level. So for example, find the required book. So for this, you first of all access catalog, access search screen, enter search criteria, because today the libraries are digitized, so you have to do this, you have to follow. Otherwise in the old libraries, the cards are available. So you have to search for the specific book, and the cards are arranged in alphabetical order. Okay, you can search with the cue from the author's name, or you can search with the title of the that material. So enter search criteria, identify required book, and note the location. That is the file, the Elmira number, or the say accession number, etc. Okay, so this is how the task is decomposed amongst various task and subtask. So it is a process of analyzing people's job, what people do, what things they work with, what they must know. Say you want to show your students how two metals are welded. Okay, so you have to go to a welder who is welding those two metals, and you will see what activities he or she is performing. First activity, second activity, third activity, and so on. Okay, and then for carrying out that particular activity, what the learner needs to know first. So it means you have to also tell how this activity is to be carried out. So let us take another example. In order to clean the room, okay, the first task is get the vacuum cleaner out, fix the appropriate attachments, clean the rooms, and when the dust bag gets full, empty it, put the vacuum cleaner and tools away. So for this one, the user must know, he must know about the vacuum cleaner, he must know what are their attachments, the dust bag, the cupboard, the room, etc. Only then he will be able to perform this activity. So task analysis is generating the hierarchy. You will begin with a goal. Goal is one. So in order to reach goal, you require number of tasks. For example, how to borrow a book, That is the goal. And for getting the book issued from the library, you have to perform number of tasks, and each task can be further broken down into various small act. Action is a small task, okay, which has no structure. Say you are looking in the almirah, simply you are picking up a particular book. This is an action, okay? So get first of all the list of tasks for reaching goal. It means you have to first of all break down the goal into two or three components, broad components, okay? Then group tasks into higher level tasks, and finally decompose lower level task further till it becomes self-sufficient, self-explanatory. No further information is needed to explain that thing. So it is the systematic identification of fundamental elements of a job, and then examination of knowledge and skills required for the job's performance. First of all, identify what are the subtasks or tasks are required. Then you need to know the knowledge component and the skill. So can you define what is knowledge? Knowledge means what does someone need to know in order to do a job. That is the theory part. And what is the skill? What does someone need to be able to do? Skill, something which requires hand and head coordination. Say working on a lathe, or say performing some experimentation in the laboratory, or even putting some entry in a ledger book. All these are the skills. So you need to know what knowledge, what skills are required for job's performance. And this information is used in human resource management for developing the instructional objectives, training program, and evaluation tool. Say you have to organize a training program. So what first activity would be, first task would be the identification of the theme, okay, broad theme. Then second would be who will be the target group. Third is the scheduling and the venue. Okay, now under the theme you will break down what topics you are going to include. Okay, then who is going to teach that particular topic, that is the identification of resource. So you are breaking down something, and if you have broken down some theory topic on a single sheet, okay, then you need not carry the bigger notes in the classroom. You can develop your lecture with the help of that one single sheet which contains the task analysis of the that particular topic. So it's very handy for a teacher. So what is task analysis? That is knowing what the users do, how they do, and why they do it. So a task analysis is an intensive examination of how people perform work activities, and I have already informed you about what is goal, what is the task, and what is an action that I have already taken. Now let me give you one illustration. Task could be any topic. Say Ohm's law, solving simultaneous equation, okay, laws of inertia, any topic from theory subject. Task could be any job, setting up a lathe, okay, or say fitting a film in a camera, or finding Young's modulus. That is a job, okay? And what is a skill? Skill is a further extension of the job, a small act. So task could be anything. Say now, what is the process of analysis? Say for teaching a particular topic, you need to first of all explain this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one. That is, you have broken down the topic or the job into five tasks or duties. You can say anything, okay? Now this is the level, this is the first level of analysis. Then level two, for explaining this particular concept, you need to explain this one and this one, okay? For explaining this fourth unit of analysis, you have to explain this one, this one, this one, this one, okay? You have to think for teaching this, what I have to explain. Okay, this is the second level of analysis. Then the third level of analysis. For teaching this particular thing, you have to teach first of all this one, this one, this one. This is third level of analysis, and then the level of level four. So you see, there are various levels, and each level produces greater detail than the one before. You see, at the top, the topic is less detailed, and at the bottom, the topic is too much detailed. That is, you will go on breaking down the topic into subtask, till it becomes self-explanatory. Now, while teaching in the classroom, you will move from the bottom. Say, you have to explain this one. Or say, let us talk about this first one. You have to explain first of all this and then this. So, once the student has understood these two tasks, he will be able to understand this first one. Okay? So, there are several levels of analysis, and each level produces greater detail than the one. So, let me take one topic. Now, with this topic, all of us are quite familiar. So, that is why I have taken this particular topic in the beginning. Level one, we have to explain the concept of human body. So, for this, we'll begin with the concept of head, concept of trunk, concept of limbs, and concept of skin. So this is the level one. Level two, for explaining the concept of head, concept of face, concept of neck, concept of back. Likewise for trunk, chest, stomach, back, shoulders, sides, for limbs, legs and arms, and for skin, color, composition and texture. This is second level of analysis. Now third level, okay, concept of face. Ears, nose, hair, cheeks, chin, mouth, eyes. For arms, upper arm, forearm, wrist, hand and elbow. Then say hand, thumb, finger, palm, back and nails. Okay, so you will go on breaking down. Okay, so this particular figure describes the task analysis principles of levels of analysis, and you see there are an increasing detail, and this also shows how each level follows logically and progressively than the one before it, isn't it? So every on a new level is followed in a sequence, in a logical order. So you can further break down. Now, I have shown you this one diagram. Can you recognize what this piece of architecture is about? Very difficult. But if you put all these components or subcomponents in a sequence, you will be able to recognize. Okay, so this shows how task analysis help the teacher or anybody to organize his or her thinking in an orderly way, and the unrelated components or parts of anything are just meaningless. ठीक है, आपने कई बार घर में ये पजल गेम भी खेली होगी, बच्चों के पास भी होता है, दे आर एबल टू ज्वाइन ऑल दीज थिंग्स, देन दैट प्रोवाइड्स यू मीनिंगफुल पिक्चर. ओके, सो नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज वेयर एंड व्हेन डू वी अप्लाई टास्क एनालिसिस. द आंसर इज एनीवेयर इट इज यूजफुल. After all, it is going to help you in organizing your thinking. You have to say, prepare, you have to say organize some program, or you have to say conduct the examination. What do? You break down that particular component into its task and then further into subtasks and into small acts. So anywhere you can apply. So in a single sheet of paper, you can view the whole topic, and it will be very easier for you to develop your lecture with the help of single sheet. So in this way, you can also maintain an eye contact with your students. You need not be dependent upon your class notes. Okay, you can move in the classroom. You can involve their participation. Now the question is that how many levels? The answer is analyze until your task or job operations are covered completely. You go on analyzing till the task becomes complete. So a step-by-step process of task analysis. First is explain why. That is, what is the goal? Only then you will be able to identify the components. Say, I want that my student should be able to understand Ohm's law. Then I will list down the content. इसको पढ़ाने के लिए बच्चे को क्या सबसे पहले पढ़ाना है या उससे पहले उसको क्या आता होना चाहिए. विल बिगिन विद व्हाट ही ऑलरेडी नोज. तभी एंड वो जो हमने सब टास्क आइडेंटिफाई कर लिए, दीज विल लीड टू द अटेनमेंट ऑफ योर ऑब्जेक्टिव. दैट इज एक्सप्लेन व्हाई. सो डेमोन्स्ट्रेट हाउ. सेट लर्निंग एक्टिविटीज. यू कैन ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड गाइडेंस बिकॉज दे मे नीड सर्टन इनपुट फ्रॉम यू एंड देन यू हैव टू परफॉर्म. यू हैव टू असेस द परफॉर्मेंस and to what level they have understood your content, and then provide them the formative feedback. Formative means that is, while they are learning, you are asking few questions and you are responding to their answers. So it means you are providing them feedback. So what are the principles of task analysis? Very simple. It is accomplished by making succeeding levels of analysis. First level, second level, third level, fourth level, until you can go on. And each level produces its own unit of analysis. You have seen first level, second level, it has its own levels of analysis. And each succeeding level is more detailed than the one before it, from which it derives. And each level of analysis and associated units of analysis follow logically and progressively from those which precede them. Jo se pehle wali hain. When considering a task analysis, you can ask yourself initially what task or what duties doing that job entail. Because in case of a theory topic, we are concerned with task and subtask. In case of a job, we are concerned with duties and sub duties or actions. Okay, you can both are the same thing, only the words are different. And what tasks are performed in each duty, and what are the elements of each task, and what are the small acts which go to make up each element, then you can carry out the task analysis. So types of task analysis, because in the institute we are concerned with theory subjects and practical subjects. So obviously we have got two types of task analysis. One is the topic analysis, second is the job analysis. But in case of job analysis, we are further concerned with the small acts, that is the skill analysis. So job is the skill is the further extension of the job, because job may involve number of skills. So one is the topic analysis, a detailed analysis of intellectual task, knowledge, theoretical, Ohm's law, solving simultaneous equation from mathematics, student evaluation, or latitude and longitude. कंसिडरिंग द करेक्टर ऑफ ब्रूटस इन शेक्सपियर जूलियस सीजर. तो मैंने डिफरेंट एग्जाम्पल्स लिए हैं, आप जो है इट मीन्स इट कैन बी अप्लाइड फॉर एनी थ्योरी टॉपिक, एनी टॉपिक फ्रॉम योर थ्योरी सब्जेक्ट्स. ओके, सेकेंड वन इज जॉब एनालिसिस, ए डिटेल्ड एनालिसिस ऑफ टास्क इन्वॉल्विंग फिजिकल और साइकोमोटर स्किल्स. साइकोमोटर, साइको मीन्स ब्रेन माइंड, मोटर मीन्स मसल्स. सो इट इज समथिंग विच रिक्वायर्स हैंड एंड हेड कोऑर्डिनेशन. सो स्किल इन्वॉल्व्स न्यूरोमस्कुलर स्किल, बोथ माइंड एंड योर मसल्स आर इन्वॉल्व, योर एक्शंस आर इन्वॉल्व. एग्जाम्पल्स हियर वी कंसंट्रेट ऑन व्हाट इज डन व्हेन इट्स व्हेन टास्क इज कैरिड आउट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल सेटिंग अप ए लेथ, वेरिफिकेशन ऑफ ओम्स लॉ, वहां हमने लिया था अंडरस्टैंड ओम्स लॉ. यहां पर बिकॉज वेरिफिकेशन ऑफ ओम्स लॉ इन्वॉल्व स्किल, दैट इज सेटिंग अप ऑफ द ऑपरेटर्स, देन मैन्युपुलेटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ वोल्टेज थ्रू रेजिस्टेंस, ओके, एंड नोटिंग द रीडिंग्स. सो यू विल नोट फोर फाइव रीडिंग्स एंड देन यू विल ड्रॉ ए ग्राफ बिटवीन वी एंड आई. Okay, so that straight line shows that the V is indirectly proportional to I. Okay, so verification of Ohm's law, even preparation of carbon dioxide gas, loading a film in a camera, wiring a plug, okay, or renewing the contact points in a car. So मैंने कई सारे example आपको दिए. Skill analysis is the further analysis of psychomotor task, but here we concentrated on how the job is accomplished. वहां job analysis में क्या था, how the job is performed, how the job is accomplished. Now because you are concerned with small small skills, small small acts, उन्हीं से आप job को accomplish करेंगे ना. पहले तो है कि आपने job को break down किया. जॉब एनालिसिस में यू हैव ब्रोकन डाउन द जॉब इनटू इट्स ड्यूटीज और सब ड्यूटीज और सब टास्क और सम एक्शंस. नाउ हियर हाउ द जॉब इज अकम्प्लिश्ड. ओके, सो व्हेन ए जॉब इज कॉम्प्लेक्स और इंट्रीगेट दैट रिक्वायर्स सटल हैंड एंड आई कोऑर्डिनेशन, देन वन मे हैव टू मेक ए स्किल एनालिसिस. ओके, सो एक्सटेंशन ऑफ जॉब एनालिसिस प्रोसीजर इज सेम एक्सेप्ट that it has at least one more level of analysis giving much more detail. Okay, you can further break down. So task analysis perform involves number of activities. One is identify the tasks to be analyzed. First is this, then break these tasks into say between 4 and 8 subtasks depending upon the amount of content you are going to cover in one lecture of say 50 minutes or 1 hour. आपने पूरे subject का नहीं करना, आपने उतने ही topic जितना आपने decide किया है for teaching in a 1 hour. Okay, so break these tasks down into between 4 and 8 subtasks, then draw the subtask as a layer diagram ensuring that it is complete. मैंने वो आपको बताया procedure, and decide upon the level of detail into which it decompose. Then continue the decomposition process ensuring that decompositions and numbering are consistent, and present the analysis to someone else who has not been involved in the decomposition but who knows that task well enough to check for the consistency. Why we have to show to some other person? So that because other person will be able to let us inform us whether we have completed each and every subtask or not. Okay, we have to see whether all the things are included or not. Kuch reh to nahi gaya. So that is why we have to show to other teacher. Now, what are the sources of information for carrying out task analysis? Ab bata sakte hain kaun se source honge for the analysis, this task analysis. One would be teacher to hai hi hai. One is teacher. books, correct? Yes, media, because internet, you will go to the internet to find out some more you can say relevant examples. Aur kya ho sakta hai? Haan ji? Yes, master. Master is a person who can perform the activity to some required level of proficiency. Say, welding two joints. You will go to the welder and note down what task or subtask he is carrying out one by one. Okay. So you have to identify the master very carefully. Why? Because if the master's proficiency level is very high and he is omitting one or two steps, but our students are average or below average. आपने एक मास्टर ने एक दो स्टेप्स स्किप कर दिए बिकॉज उसने दो तीन स्टेप्स को इकट्ठा परफॉर्म कर लिया देन इट विल बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर ए स्टूडेंट हु इज वेरी एवरेज और बिलो एवरेज बट इफ द स्टूडेंट्स आर वेरी इंटेलिजेंट एंड द प्रोफिशिएंसी लेवल ऑफ द मास्टर इज मीडियोकर और से बिलो एवरेज सो ही इज परफॉर्मिंग ईच एंड एवरी स्टेप स्मॉल स्मॉल स्टेप देन इट विल बी बोरिंग फॉर द इंटेलिजेंट स्टूडेंट यार क्या छोटे से स्टेप को बता रहा है क्यों नहीं तीन चार इकट्ठे कर दें ऐसा होता है ना सो यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द मास्टर वेरी केयरफुली सो स्टूडेंट्स दैट इज पास्ड आउट स्टूडेंट्स उनसे आप लेंगे इंफॉर्मेशन द मास्टर द टीचर द कोर्स मटेरियल इवन एग्जामिनेशन में कौन से क्वेश्चन आए किस तरह के क्वेश्चन आए राइट तो आप उस तरह से टास्क रिसीव करेंगे ताकि उनको भी आप एड्रेस कर सको एंड देन दी क्लाइंट क्लाइंट कौन सा है जहां पर हमारा बच्चा जो है वो जॉब में जाएगा राइट सो दिस इज टास्क एनालिसिस एंड व्हाट आर दी प्रोसीजर्स फॉर कलेक्टिंग द इंफॉर्मेशन वन इज ऑब्जर्वेशन ठीक है आप वेल्डर को देख रहे हैं कि दो ज्वाइंट वेल्ड कर रहा है तो यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग ए चेकलिस्ट पहले ये एक्टिविटी फिर ठीक है तो जब बच्चे ने परफॉर्म करना है यू विल ऑब्जर्व वेदर ही हैज परफॉर्म दिस और नॉट आप टिक टिक लगाते जाएंगे सो ऑब्जर्वेशन और यू कैन ऑल्सो गो फॉर इंटरव्यू यू कैन ऑल्सो प्रिपेयर क्वेश्चनियर वर्क डायरी और यू कैन ऑल्सो प्रिपेयर ए वीडियो रिकॉर्डिंग यू कैन वीडियो रिकॉर्ड द प्रोसीजर विच इज एंड देन द जॉब चेकलिस्ट और एक्टिविटी लिस्ट सो दीज आर द टूल्स फॉर द कलेक्शन ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन Now, I'll take few examples from different fields. From mechanical, say job of an engine mechanic. Okay, you see how this job is broken down into task and subtask. So you can because it is job, you can say it is duty or task. कुछ भी आप कह सकते हैं. The first duty of the engine mechanic is to tune the carburetor adjusting tappets adjusting spark plug gap changing engine oil and cleaning the spark plug okay now further let us break down one of these tasks into sub task changing engine oil okay for this aapne notice kiya hai This is the first activity that is the mechanic will jack up the car he will place oil container under the sump and then remove the sump plug and finally he will allow the oil to drain away so all these have been written in a sequence so all these are performed one by one theek hai now let us take the jacking up the car aap mujhe batayenge isme फर्दर एलिमेंट्स क्या हो सकते हैं यस हाँ जैक को आइडेंटिफाई करना बिकॉज जैक बहुत सारे अवेलेबल हैं और क्या होगा आपने देखा होगा इंजन ऑयल कैसे चेंज होता है
कि जो हमारा जो जैक है वो खा लगेगा
प्लेसिंग प्लेसिंग वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, कहीं भी नहीं आप जैक को लगा सकते, गाड़ी का वो जो है वो चेसी टूट जाएगी. ओके सो प्लेसमेंट इज अनदर सब टास्क. और क्या इंपॉर्टेंट है, वो प्लेसमेंट हो गया ना, दैट इज अ प्लेसमेंट. एंड देन मैन्युपुलेशन, किस हाइट तक लेके जाना है ताकि वो व्यक्ति जो है नीचे घुस जाए. ओके सो यू सी अक्वायरिंग राइट काइंड ऑफ जैक, पोजिशनिंग द जैक एंड मैन्युपुलेटिंग द जैक टू सम हाइट. तो देखो आपने एक टास्क को किस कितनी सारे सब टास्क में डिवाइड कर दिया. नाउ यू कैन शो टू योर फ्रेंड कि भी इसमें कुछ और मिसिंग तो नहीं है. लाइकवाइज यू कैन गो फॉर प्लेसिंग ऑयल कंटेनर, रिमूविंग सम प्लग, अलाउइंग ऑयल टू ड्रेन अवे. यू कैन कैरी आउट द टास्क एनालिसिस. से टॉपिक इज फोर्स, कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ फोर्स एंड न्यूटन्स लॉज ऑफ मोशन. दिस इज द फर्स्ट लेवल. ओके नाउ कॉन्सेप्ट को हमने सेकेंड लेवल में ब्रेक डाउन किया, डेफिनेशन, द इफेक्ट एंड द यूनिट्स. देन हमने इफेक्ट को फर्दर लेवल में एनालाइज किया, दैट इज स्पीड, द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ स्पीड, कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डायरेक्शन, कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ शेप. ओके सो न्यूटन्स लॉज ऑफ मोशन, फर्स्ट लॉ, सेकेंड लॉ, थर्ड लॉ. तो आई हैव टेकन फर्स्ट लॉ ओनली. तो फर्स्ट लॉ को हमने डिवाइड किया, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल स्टेटमेंट, देन एप्लीकेशन, देन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इनर्शिया. अब इनर्शिया को फर्दर डिवाइड किया, उसके लिए कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ रेस्ट पढ़ाना है, कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मोशन एंड कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डायरेक्शन. सो दिस इज हाउ द टॉपिक इज एनालाइज इन टू इट्स टास्क एंड सब टास्क. लेट अस टेक अनदर थ्योरी ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी, जूल्स लॉ एंड ओम्स लॉ. ओके नाउ वन ऑफ देम इज ओम्स लॉ. फॉर दिस द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज पहले पढ़ाएंगे, कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट, देन कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ EMF, कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस, कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, देन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ओम्स लॉ. ओके दिस इज द सेकंड लेवल. थर्ड लेवल पे हमने इलेक्ट्रिकल चार्ज को ब्रेक डाउन किया, दैट इलेक्ट्रॉन इज द बेसिक यूनिट ऑफ चार्ज, करंट इज द फ्लो ऑफ चार्ज, कूलम इज द प्रैक्टिकल यूनिट ऑफ चार्ज. देन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट को हमने ब्रेक डाउन किया, करंट इज द फ्लो ऑफ चार्ज, कूलम पर सेकंड इज एम्पियर. व्हेन करंट फ्लोज वर्क इज डन, एनर्जी यूज्ड व्हेन वर्क इज डन, एनर्जी सप्लाइड फॉर करंट टू फ्लो. सो बिकॉज ऑफ स्केर्सिटी ऑफ स्पेस मैंने प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ओम्स लॉ ले लिया. ओके यू कैन टेक ए ब्रॉडर पेज, बिगर पेज. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दैट वी इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू करंट, एंड वी इज इक्वल टू सी इनटू कांस्टेंट, कांस्टेंट इज रेजिस्टेंस. सो देन आर इज इक्वल टू वी बाय सी, सो रेजिस्टेंस इज वी बाय सी. ओके देन अनदर इज सॉल्विंग नेटवर्क्स बाय किरचॉफ्स लॉ, फर्स्ट लॉ, सेकेंड लॉ एंड सॉल्विंग नेटवर्क्स. नाउ सेकेंड लेवल, फर्स्ट लॉ को पढ़ाने से पहले यू हैव टू एक्सप्लेन द नेटवर्क ऑफ कंडक्टर्स, द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ करंट, द अलजेब्रिक सम एंड देन द फर्स्ट लॉ. सो व्हाट इज नेटवर्क ऑफ कंडक्टर्स? कंडक्टर्स आर द सबस्टांसेस विच ऑफर लिटिल रेजिस्टेंस एंड देन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ नेटवर्क. उसका डायग्राम इसको फर्दर आप डिवाइड कर सकते हो. देन करंट इज द फ्लो ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन और कूलम पर सेकंड इज द यूनिट एंड देन द फर्स्ट लॉ. उसके दो एस्पेक्ट हो गए, इनको फर्दर आप ब्रेक डाउन कर सकते हो. देन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस एंड देन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ EMF यू कैन ब्रेक डाउन. ओके लेट अस टेक वन मोर टॉपिक, वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग, ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट फिल्म प्रोसेसिंग. आप में से कितने लोगों ने देखी है? शायद किसी ने नहीं देखी. थोड़ा सा आपको पुरानी दुनिया में ले चलते हैं. ओके सो हाउ ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट फिल्म्स वर प्रोसेस्ड? पहला, देयर आर थ्री एक्टिविटीज. वन ऑफ देम इज मेंटेनिंग सेफ्टी इन द डार्क रूम. उस समय डार्क रूम होना चाहिए था, ठीक है? सो मेंटेनिंग सेफ्टी इन द डार्क रूम एंड वन ऑफ द एक्टिविटीज अकाउंटिंग फॉर पर्सनल सेफ्टी बिकॉज देयर इज डार्क इनसाइड एंड वन ऑफ द एक्टिविटीज अकाउंटिंग फॉर पर्सनल सेफ्टी. नाउ This has been broken down into 8 sub-tasks. आप देखेंगे ये सारे के सारे चाहिए, उसी से you can account for personal safety. One is, first of all, describe the risk exaggerated because of darkness. बच्चे को आप पढ़ा रहे हो how to process black and white film. तो first of all, you need to explain what are the risks involved in the dark, then explain the importance of orientation within the dark room. कहाँ पर wash basin है, कहाँ पर developer पड़ा है, कहाँ पर जो है दूसरे chemicals पड़े हैं, orientation, left hand side में क्या रखना, right hand side में, and so on. Then name the chemicals in use. Okay. Then describe the individual danger of each chemical. Then state the dangers arising from spillages. Then point out need for consideration for the safety of other. Maybe some other person is also working along with you. So point out the need for consideration. Then demonstrate the importance of awareness in the dark and explain clearly the emergency procedure for the dark room. So humne topic ko breakdown kiya. Let us take from civil engineering, collection of soil sample by auger boring. Okay. Level one, selecting the equipment. Okay. Level two, locate and clean site. Make a bore hole and collect the sample. यानी हमने पहले में broad activities एक sequence में लिख दी. अब उनको फर्दर हम ब्रेक डाउन कर रहे हैं. से सेलेक्टिंग इक्विपमेंट, आइडेंटिफाई इक्विपमेंट एंड चूज द सूटेबल ऑगर. लोकेट एंड क्लीन साइट के लिए पहले पहले आइडेंटिफाई साइट, लोकेट साइट एंड क्लीन साइट. फॉर क्लीनिंग साइट रिमूव ग्रास फ्रॉम द टेस्ट साइट एंड लैंड सरफेस यूजिंग एप्रोप्रिएट टूल, ताकि मिट्टी जो रैंडमली, सॉइल जो है रैंडमली सेलेक्ट किया जा सके. पहले यू हैव टू रिमूव द ग्रास एंड देन यू हैव टू लैंड द सरफेस यूजिंग सम टूल्स. ओके. Then make a bore hole. For this, you need to know how the auger is operated. And for that, first of all, you have to assemble the auger. कैसे assemble करना है? Fix drill rod, fix T junction, and insert the handle. Clean auger. यानी पहले से कोई sample, कोई soil के components तो नहीं है. Then position auger on the test surface. And then insert auger into soil by rotating auger and by pushing. Yani rotate bhi kare, push bhi kare, tabhi wo inside jayega. And then you have to collect the sample. For this, remove auger from the hole, remove soil from the auger, then collect the soil in the polythene and then seal the envelope. So this is the procedure. How all the components are included in one page. DC motors, principle, construction, working, then principle में concept of magnetic field, concept of alignment of magnetic field, concept of torque angle, concept of brush and commutator arrangement, and you are further breaking down. Wiring a plug from electrical engineering, okay. At the level one, concept of color code, preparing leads, attaching leads. And safety checks, ठीक है. उसके further task क्या हैं? Color code में new code, old code and twin flux, okay. Prepare leads, remove cover, remove the outer insulation, identify terminal, cut the leads and strip the leads. ऐसे ही करते हैं ना. Then attaching leads, twist standards. हाथ से जहां उसे करते हैं. देन राउट द लीड्स, रैप लीड्स अराउंड द टर्मिनल, टाइटन द टर्मिनल नट्स एंड सिक्योर ग्रिपर बार. एंड व्हाट आर द सेफ्टी चेक्स? पोलैरिटी, सिक्योरिटी ऑफ लीड्स एंड फ्लक्स, करेक्टिंग वैल्यू फ्यूज एंड देन रिप्लेसिंग द कवर. सॉल्विंग मैथमेटिकल प्रॉब्लम बाय यूजिंग लॉग टेबल. मैथमेटिक्स में से एग्जाम्पल लिया. वन दैट वी हैव ब्रोकन डाउन इनटू से फोर कंपोनेंट. वन इज मल्टीप्लाइंग टू नंबर्स, सेकंड इज डिवाइडिंग वन नंबर बाय अनदर नॉन जीरो नंबर, देन सब्ट्रैक्टिंग वन नंबर फ्रॉम अदर, और फाइंडिंग ए टू पावर बी. अब मैंने इसको डेसिमल क्लासिफिकेशन दिया है. आप इस तरह से भी इसको ब्रेक डाउन कर सकते हैं. से 1.1, इसका मीनिंग क्या है? दिस इज फर्स्ट टास्क अंडर फर्स्ट टास्क मल्टीप्लाइंग टू नंबर. दिस इज फर्स्ट सब टास्क अंडर टास्क मल्टीप्लाइंग टू नंबर 1.1. So finding the characteristics and mentees of two numbers. पहले ये करना पड़ेगा. Then adding the logarithm together. Then anti-logging the sum. Fixing the decimal point. And connecting answer to appropriate number of significant figures. उसके बाद हाँ ये निकालना पड़ेगा ना मेंटीसा. इसमें होता है मेंटीसा एंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. ओके आप भूल गए शायद मैथमेटिक्स में लॉग टेबल यूज नहीं कभी किया. भूल गए टेंथ में पढ़ाया था. ओके सो 1.1.1 ये सब टास्क है फॉर सब टास्क फाइंडिंग द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स एंड मेंटीसा ऑफ टू नंबर्स. सो सबसे पहले लोकेटिंग फर्स्ट टू सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर्स ऑफ ईच नंबर इन लेफ्ट हैंड कॉलम ऑफ द लॉग टेबल. Then locating the third figure of each number in appropriate middle column headed 0 to 9 and locating the fourth figure in add column headed 0 to 9 on the right hand side of the page. तो हमने पूरी टास्क को एनालाइज कर दिया पूरे टॉपिक को एनालाइज कर दिया. ओके सो दिस इज अनदर एग्जाम्पल दैट इज ऑपरेट एंड प्रिंट अ लेटर यूजिंग माइक्रोसॉफ्ट वर्ड. सो एंटर वर्ड प्रोसेसर एंटर टेक्स्ट format text, edit text, save file, print file, leave word processor and likewise you are breaking down into various subtasks and sub-sub-tasks and sub-sub-sub-tasks and till it becomes self-explanatory. Now, what are the rules for sequencing? That is for sequencing various elements in the task analysis. One is proceeding from what your students already know to what they do not know. So you will begin your lecture with what they already know. Because if you start with what they do not know, they will not accept it easily. For example, if I start with my lecture, I come to my classroom, I say, today I am going to talk to you about inertia. Say students of class 7 are sitting here. They have not heard about inertia and they will not accept it. So what I will do, I will begin with what they already know. I'll place this object on the table and I'll ask, what is the position of this object? Is it moving or is it at rest? You will definitely say that it is at rest. And I'll ask, what is the position of this fan? You will say that it is in motion. Wonderful. Now, this is at rest and fan is in motion. How can I bring this object into motion? You will say that by pushing or by pulling, that is by applying some force, it can be put into motion. Wonderful. And you are sitting in a moving bus. And the driver suddenly applies brakes. What happens? We go forward. And what happens when the driver suddenly starts the bus? We go backward. Why are these you two? Okay. Now they are quite motivated because they already know about the concept of rest, concept of motion. And you have also explained the concept of force day before yesterday. Okay. Then you will say that these are due to laws of inertia. So today, in this session, we will learn about inertia. So you will proceed from known to unknown. Okay. Second one is you will proceed from simple to difficult. This is another psychological principle because you have to, you can say, increase the complexity of something slowly and slowly. You will begin with simple task and then you will slowly move to the difficult task. Another principle is moving from concrete to abstract. What is concrete? Something which is composed of many masses. Say this is an example of concrete concept of duster. Okay, then concept of laptop, concept of fan, concept of tube light. These are concrete concepts. Why? Because you can see these are the tangible objects. So you have to begin with concrete things first. क्योंकि स्टूडेंट जो है पहले वो चीज पसंद करते हैं फिजिकल या यू हैव टू गिव देम एग्जांपल्स. So concrete to abstract. Abstract kya hota hai? Something which you cannot see. Something which is reduced to summary. For example, concept of force. अगर आप डिक्शनरी में वर्ड फोर्स का मीनिंग देखेंगे, यू विल नॉट गेट वन मीनिंग. फोर्स एज वर्ब अलग मीनिंग है, फोर्स एज एडजेक्टिव अलग है. ओके, इट मींस यू नीड टू डिफाइन इन ए पर्टिकुलर कॉन्टेक्स्ट. दैट इज व्हाई दीज आर एब्स्ट्रैक्ट कॉन्सेप्ट्स. और एब्स्ट्रैक्ट कॉन्सेप्ट को अपने कॉन्क्रीटाइज करना विद द हेल्प ऑफ एग्जाम्पल्स. कई बार क्या होता है आपके जो थ्योरी सब्जेक्ट्स में देयर आर मेनी सिचुएशन वेयर यू कैन नॉट ब्रिंग द एक्चुअल ऑब्जेक्ट इन द क्लासरूम. ओके, तो उस समय क्या करते हैं, यू ब्रिंग द कॉन्ट्राइव्ड एक्सपीरियंसेस इन द क्लासरूम इन द फॉर्म ऑफ मॉडल, और यू ब्रिंग चार्ट शोइंग दैट पिक्चर. ओके, और यू रिलेट द कंटेंट विद एग्जाम्पल्स फ्रॉम वर्ड ऑफ वर्क. The idea is to concretize. So, आपने पहले तो आपने ऑब्जेक्ट से, रियल ऑब्जेक्ट से या मॉडल से या पिक्चर से या मोशन से, वीडियो से concretize किया. और जहां पर ये चीजें नहीं अवेलेबल, यू आर गिविंग them relevant examples. So that meaningful learning should take place. Okay. So this is the third rule. Fourth is proceed from observation to reasoning. वो क्या होता है, यू आर शोइंग देम सर्टन एग्जाम्पल्स एंड देन आस्क देम कैन यू जनरलाइज. से मैंने आई हैव शोन यू. ओके, सो नाउ कैन यू जनरलाइज. आई कैन से ऑल बॉडीज आर अट्रैक्टिव टूवर्ड्स अर्थ. ऑब्जर्वेशन टू रीजनिंग, हमने उनको कुछ सिचुएशन देनी है सो दैट दे कैन थिंक अबाउट इट एंड दे कैन गिव रीजनिंग व्हाई दिस हैज हैपेंड. ओके, सो यू हैव टू प्रोसीड फ्रॉम ऑब्जर्वेशन टू रीजनिंग एंड फॉलोइंग ए करेक्ट क्रोनोलॉजिकल ऑर्डर. सिंपल टू डिफिकल्ट यू हैव टू फॉलो. इसको पढ़ाने के लिए क्या पढ़ाना है, इसको पढ़ाने के लिए क्या पढ़ाना है, लाइक दैट. So, steps for implementation, task analysis steps. One is identify the target task or a skill. Topic is there. What subtasks are required to reach that particular topic? So, identify. Then identify the prerequisite skills of the learner, what he already knows. And what materials are needed to teach that particular task, वो भी चाहिए आपको. ठीक है ना, कि बच्चे को पहले से क्या आता होना चाहिए. And then for teaching this particular thing, what things you need, कौन सा equipment चाहिए, कौन सी material चाहिए, chart, picture, diagram, कौन सा चाहिए. So determine whether the learner has the required prerequisite skills needed to learn the task. तो आपने assume किया, जैसे मैंने टॉपिक लिया था इन लॉज ऑफ इनर्शिया. सो बिफोर गोइंग इनटू द क्लासरूम आई अज्यूम दैट माय स्टूडेंट्स मस्ट बी फैमिलियर विद द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ रेस्ट, मोशन एंड फोर्स. मैंने अज्यूम किया. नाउ व्हेन आई कम टू द क्लासरूम आई विल टेस्ट फॉर दोज प्रीरिक्विजिट्स. तो मैंने क्या किया, मैंने पूछा, यस व्हाट इज द पोजीशन ऑफ दिस ऑब्जेक्ट, इज इट एट रेस्ट और इज इट मूविंग, यू सेड इट इज एट रेस्ट. What is the position of this fan? You said it is in motion. It is at rest. How can I bring it into motion? You said by applying some force. So I have tested that my students possess requisite knowledge prior to giving new instruction. So, and define the necessary materials needed to teach the task. Then another step is breaking the task or the content or the skill into its constituent elements. Okay, so break skills down into smaller steps and then determine the relationship among these elements. So relationship bhi, kyunki maine shuru mein bola tha, it involves two activities. One is the analysis, second is the synthesis. Unko jodna bhi hai. And the fourth step is confirming that the task is completely analyzed. So you will discuss with your friends, colleagues, and you will go to some internet to see whether the specific information is this much or something else. Okay, confirm. And then step five is determine how the skill will be taught. Yeah, how the topic will be taught, whether you require lecture method, whether you require demonstration method, or say problem based learning method, which method you will take, which media you will carry. Okay, aapne isko implement karna hai, theek hai. And then implementing the intervention and monitoring progress. So you will give them or you will ask them few questions, monitor karenge kaun se question puche jayenge classroom mein. Okay, and then you will give them some assignment by which we want to see whether the students are able to translate or transfer the classroom learning into a new situation. So that is why you will implement the intervention and monitor the progress. So at the end, what are the benefits of task analysis? This is the beginning for the planning of your lecture. So it will help you design your lecture, help you prepare your lecture, and it will make sure that you have received all that the learners need to know. It will also ensure that all the fundamental parts of the job or the topic or the skill are covered, because you are discussing with your friends, colleagues, and you will also be able to know the steps presented in natural order. There is no repetition. All are in sequence, one by one they are performed, and this will help you to give a basis for setting test questions. जैसे मैंने एनालाइज किया था, मैंने क्या किया, करंट को डिवाइड किया डेफिनेशन, डिवाइस एंड यूनिट. यहीं से आप क्वेश्चन बना सकते हो. आई कैन से डिफाइन करंट, नेम द एसआई यूनिट ऑफ करंट, और आई से नेम द डिवाइस व्हिच मेजर्स करंट, एंड फॉर यूनिट स्टेट द एसआई यूनिट ऑफ करंट. तो इट मींस जब आपने एनालिसिस कर ली, यू कैन थिंक अबाउट सो मेनी स्मॉल स्मॉल क्वेश्चंस. ओके, सो इट विल हेल्प यू फॉर सेटिंग टेस्ट क्वेश्चंस एंड टेस्ट प्रोसीजर्स वेयर स्किल्स आर इन्वॉल्व्ड, एंड इट विल आल्सो हेल्प यू टू फॉर्मुलेट योर ऑब्जेक्टिव. आपने ऑब्जेक्टिव फॉर्मुलेट कर दिए. से मैंने ओम ला ऊपर लिखा, तो इसको मैंने लर्निंग आउटकम कैसे बोलूंगा, दैट आफ्टर द टॉपिक इज ओवर my students will be able to understand Ohm's law. Broad objective, learning outcome. Ab in broad learning outcomes ko achieve karne ke liye I will formulate specific objectives, that after the topic is over my student will be able to explain the concept of current, they will be able to explain the concept of voltage, they will be able to draw the circuit diagram, will be able to draw the circuit diagram, they will be able to verify Ohm's law, they will be able to draw a graph between V and I, and they will be able to list situations where Ohm's law can be applicable. So ye maine broad objective aur specific objective banaye, jo professor Tulsi kal subah aapke samne learning outcome ka topic lenge, theek hai, wo yahi hoga. So learning outcome you can write only if you have carried out task analysis very carefully, and I think you will appreciate that if you have got this one task analysis, one page analysis with you, you can develop your lecture with the help of this sheet. You need not carry the large notes in the classroom, kyunki aap wahan se dictate karte hain, ya say you are looking at your notes, so usme kya hota hai, आपका आई कॉन्टेक्ट स्टूडेंट के साथ टूट जाता है. नाउ विद द हेल्प ऑफ वन पेज, आप जस्ट आपने देखा हल्का, देन यू कैन फेस द ऑडियंस. सो दिस इज अबाउट द टास्क एनालिसिस. ओके, एंड इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन और एनी क्वेरी, यू आर वेलकम. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल आस्क ऑल ऑफ यू हु आर सिटिंग हियर, इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी, यू आर वेलकम.